Hello. So, this is a little, like, PSA kind of, pre-intro. I tried something new with this podcast, and, we recorded this on Discord. So, the audio might sound a little bit wonky because it's on Discord and not in front of my mic that I'm using right now. So, it's gonna be a test for, see how it is. So, do bear with, how wonky it sounds. I do apologize. But, hopefully in the near future, I find out how to work it. Recording on Discord and everything. So, until then, enjoy the show. Hello, people of the Nestcast. Welcome back to another episode. I have a guest today. And his name is Bryan. You might remember him. So, Bryan, say hello.
Oh, hi.
So Brian's here today, and the topic today is a little calmer than the last one from what I had the previous episode. We're talking about music, and not just any type of music. We're talking about musical scores in movies. So, that's right. So, Bryan, give us your background on musical scores for movies.
Well, you know, I really enjoy listening to scores and certain soundtracks from movies, specifically animated movies.
Yeah, so I guess what I don't know. I guess I've always been really a fan. I always love music. I love film. I love movies, and I love the soundtrack. See, because when you're watching a movie, it's, you know, the music there is to help provide an emotion. Specifically, it's to provide an emotion for the audience and for the people, and you can do that wonderfully with music. It's, you know, almost every animated movie that I've seen has had really, really good music. And it's just something about it. To me, it's very special, and I really love it a lot. Personally, for me, it's just a brain itch, and it's just, it's just fun to listen to. And I like listening to all kinds of music, so scores aren't very much that different.
The scores for animation movies, I feel like they're better, in my opinion, than like the live action ones. I don't know, they hit more than the live action ones. I don't know if you've seen like live action scores or.
Well, I don't see a whole lot of films. I don't see a whole lot of movies that aren't animated. So I mostly just watch animated movies, and I love the scores in almost every single one. Because they're fun, they're exciting. They're not just for kids, but they're to entertain. And I don't know, I love it a lot. I'm very connected with a lot of music.
Yeah. I mean, us, like me and you, we're in our school's orchestra, and obviously we love music because of how long we've been in the orchestra. So we're kind of used to that score type of sound already because of the orchestra.
I would listen whenever. So, being really young, and I remember, like, I absolutely love animated movies. There's just something about them that I don't think any live action movie could really capture. Animation, really, it breaks boundaries of what live action or not animated movies can do. I mean, there's films out there that aren't animated that are considered very, 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 very good, and well received. Yeah. But for me, animation is a medium that breaks the boundaries of reality and can make literally everything possible. And the music, it not like along with the animation, with its story and its characters, and just how the art style, the music also carries, can carry that emotion as well to bring to an audience. Mm-hmm. So I remember, like, I would watch any animated movie, and I would specifically, I love everything going on screen, but it's what I was hearing that really made it such a great film. Like that action and the suspense, and there's the conflicts and everything that's happening. It's all portrayed by the music, and it's really, really cool. Such a, I don't know, it's just great. It's amazing. And yeah, ever since then, you know, I listen to those scores in my free time anyway, because
I can see.
I have a deep passion for animation and for music and for film, so it's just kind of a good combo, I guess.
I mean movie wise, like film wise, I'm more of a live action guy, but when there's one animation movie that really hits, I fall in love with it, and the score along with it, it just it fits. It makes the movie better.
Yeah, it can significantly make it way better. Because there's a lot of animated movie scores and soundtracks that I love. See, here's the thing between a soundtrack and a score. So basically, a score is the orchestral pieces or tracks in a film. The soundtrack are usually the songs that are played within the music, not within the music, within the film, that are provided by artists. The score is usually composed by, you know, with a composer, and with usually it's orchestra related.
Yeah.
Or band. Or other instruments, depending on the film, on the movie. Yeah. But I tend to like scores more than soundtracks, but both I honestly really enjoy, especially if the songs from the movie are really, really good.
Yeah.
Really, really perfect example of this is Into the Spider-Verse.
Yes.
Score and soundtrack.
Their soundtrack in the
score. I love the soundtrack. I love all the songs, well, most of the songs. But I listen to the score probably religiously.
I could just imagine your Apple Music status, like, every day, if there was one for, like, Discord or whatever, just every day, like, listening on Apple Music, and then it's just a score name.
You know, you're making a Spider-Man film, and it's got to be, it's the coming of a new hero, you know, Miles Morales. So you need to have very emotional and very intense music to go along with it, you know. Yes. And you have to have like a theme for the character that plays out through the movie. And it's very notable when you watch the movie itself. So the music really, it does a lot of things. The music is very important when it comes to...
Yeah, it can do a lot. It can be the story. It can lead the story.
Exactly.
It can do whatever. It
does a lot.
Obviously, it can be really dramatic. It can be really loud. It's honestly amazing.
Yeah, and it's sometimes even the quieter pieces that really get to me, really itch my brain. it just brings that emotion, that important emotion that is needed in the movie. So, that's a really, really good example. And And yeah.
Yeah. Honestly, for the next Spider-Verse film, I'm really excited because Metro Boomin is making the soundtrack. I don't know about if he's doing the score as well, because he's a really good producer. But I'm truly excited for the film in June this year. Yeah. To see what Metro Boomin can bring to the table for this Spider-Man film.
You know, I'm excited. I'm excited to hear the soundtrack, because Post Malone did a wonderful job. I think most of the artists did. I really like their songs on the soundtrack.
Yeah.
I'm also excited for the score too. I'm really excited to see what they're going to do.
I mean, just from the few bits that we got from the trailer not too long ago, they sound sick.
Well, actually, that's from the first film.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they've used certain certain pieces from the score and put it into the trailer. And I know that because I've listened to them a lot, and I can easily recognize. See, that's the cool thing. When you listen to scores into music like that, you can instantly recognize scenes' importance, and you can just recognize, like, you know, it's there. And,
Oh, and for you uncultured, no, I'm just kidding. For you rap fans, when we're talking about orchestral and soundtracks, we're talking, so Metro Boomin dropped his album, and then he drops an instrumental. So words and no words.
No, I mean, yeah. I mean, no, I don't listen to a lot of rap music. But I do like any music that is just catchy in general, or that I just enjoy.
I got you hooked on The Weeknd and Tyler the Creator, bro.
Yeah.
And Frank.
Yeah, but it's not like very common for me to listen to rap all the time. I'll just listen to whatever, except country, maybe. No offense against country music fans. I'm just like, no.
Hey, you're gonna be like Fluffy one day. You're gonna turn on that radio, and then you're just gonna ball out to the country song.
Yeah, I guess that's the day when my dignity will die.
Oh my god. But scores can be a lot. It can make or break a film, in my opinion. Mainly make, but
for me, if a movie, specifically if an animated movie is bad, but the song, the music is good, then I'm like, okay, it's a pass. Passable. It's a pass. I can, fine.
You'll tolerate it?
I can tolerate it, yeah. And not just scores from movies either. It's also a video game thing as well. It's also video game soundtracks are also, they're pretty controversial because people say it's not real music. But I believe that video game soundtracks and OSTs are real music because, I mean, what can you define as like real music? And music can be really anything. It doesn't have to be
set. Actually, speaking of, we're gonna talk about gaming soundtracks for another episode. But while we're on the topic, just a little like fun fact: this year at the Grammys, they actually put gaming soundtracks as one of their nomination lists.
Did they?
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure Assassin's Creed won one.
It's good. It's good that it's getting recognition as like actual music that people are making. You know, it's just because it's for games doesn't make it any less important, because
I mean, I was one of those.
Even in games, no matter what game, the music can still bring that emotion to a player. It can along with the music, along with the scenery, along with the story, it makes it such a wonderful moment when you're playing a game. And it's what makes a game unique with all those aspects tied together. It's what makes it really, really good.
Yeah. God of War. Anyway, so.
But, yeah. So I my favorite video game soundtrack is the Minecraft soundtrack.
I think me personally, Minecraft can't be topped. Like, there are certain gaming soundtracks that are like really close to it, but I'm pretty sure nothing can top
The Minecraft soundtrack. Is one that I don't think will ever leave my life. I don't think
to
me, Minecraft soundtrack isn't just like music. It's not just, you know, something to play in the background.
It's the game.
It's an experience. It's an experience that you go through when you grow up in your life. The first time you play that game and the music starts playing, you don't think much of it.
Yeah, we've been playing Minecraft since like what, 2015, 14, maybe earlier if you're that cool.
But yeah, it's when you first play the game and you hear the music, you don't think much of it. You just think, oh, it's a nice piano melody. It's a nice, calm, kind of calm music. Just, you know, you're alone in this world. It fits. It doesn't leave you completely in solitude.
When I'm doing homework, occasionally I just pop that soundtrack on.
Yeah.
And I just do my homework to it and boom.
Yeah, but when you grow older and when you kind of reflect back, when you after all these years, you go back and you play the game again, and the music, when you hear it, suddenly
you get nostalgic.
It brings you back to the first time you heard it, and you start to appreciate, you know, all the fun times that you had with it. You didn't realize that you were having fun playing Minecraft, but the music just brings you back to that time, whether it be out of nostalgia or, you know. So it can really be special to a lot of people because it brings them back to a more simpler time. Once they're adults or fully grown up, they go back and they just hear the music, and it can even be emotional for them because it's like an experience when you hear it.
It's an experience.
So I love
the soundtrack. I think the Minecraft soundtrack will never leave our hearts.
It's very good, especially when I play in creative. Because certain tracks only play in survival or in creative.
And then certain tracks in,
So I like both, but I'm personally more nostalgia with the creative soundtrack.
Yeah.
For the game. Because I've probably spent more time in creative than in survival.
I mean, listen, bro, me and you, you know, we got that one world that we'll talk another day about. We got that one world that we spent like most of quarantine on, and oh my god.
Yeah.
It's engraved in our heads at this point.
Yeah, so I can't wait for the music to just be a memory, but at the same time, you know, I really want to appreciate it as much as I can because
you still have it.
Yeah, I still have it.
With every update, you know, there's more music getting added, and it's truly amazing.
It can bring an experience for new players as well.
Yeah. You know? We'll stop on the video game soundtracks. We'll talk about that in another episode. But back to movies. What are your top five favorite movie soundtracks?
I have a list. I actually have my Apple podcast, not podcast, my Apple playlist, specifically for soundtracks and movie scores.
Oh yeah, you do.
because it's I love to hear it. It's Some of it's filled with like really popular movies. Others more obscure, but I don't care. I'll just kind of put them in a list and then just shuffle in between them. I guess the reason why I love it so much is because it's like imagining, because I like to imagine a lot. I love to think about stories and think about characters and all that. So I like to think of scenarios, and I like to make up these stories in my head when listening to the music. And the music itself can be the story. If you listen closely, it can help you kind of know what the mood is of a scene without even watching it. So I think that's also one of the cool things about it. And not just from animated, but just from movies in general, the score can really be important, and the music can just be phenomenal if done right. So I guess my favorites, I'll say my favorites, and then I'll give a reason why I really like them.
Yeah, for sure.
Besides like listening to them nonstop. I love they won't be in rank, but I love the Soul soundtrack, Disney Pixar's Soul, that came out a couple years back. I love the movie for its concept, for its abstract concept, and I really wanted to see how they would have done it, how they would have made this fictional world that none of us have ever seen. And, you know, we got composers, Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross. These guys, you may not be familiar, but they're the people who are behind Nine Inch Nails concerts. And I heard some, I haven't heard their other music, but I heard that they're really good. And they composed the soundtrack for Soul, along with John, what's his name? John Batiste, for the jazz arrangements. So I love both the jazz arrangements, and I love the kind of soft techno feel to two opposite. It's two opposite genres of music for two opposite worlds. So that right there is perfect. And I love the melodies. I love the tunes. I especially really love Epiphany, which is one of the songs in the soundtrack, because it's really an epiphany. It's that time. It's kind of the climax. I won't spoil the movie, but it's such a turning point in the main character's journey, and can be reflected upon yourself. And I love to listen to it because it's really soft. It mixes both the jazz arrangements, not really jazz, but the piano, the slow piano, along with the soft techno music. So it's really something. I really like DreamWorks soundtracks, actually. Now I'm looking back, and I especially love the Kung Fu Panda soundtracks and scores. They especially the second one. I think the second one, I've heard it so many times, and I've listened to almost every song on there, and every single one is just phenomenal. I think what were their names? John Powell, I believe, and Hans Zimmer. Those guys are legendary, amazing, top tier composers. Really, it's phenomenal. I love their music. It's really, oh man. When you rewatch the movies, it's you can feel it. It's got, you know, it's incorporated the Chinese culture into its music, and it did it so perfectly. And I won't spoil any of the movies I talk about, but there's a scene in Kung Fu Panda 2 that really gets me every time. And the music, just the music alone, can make me tear up just because of how impactful it is. I love it. I love it. I love the intensity in some scenes. I love the kind of the cheerful and kind of almost goofy kind of soundtrack to balance it out, along with the emotional pieces. So it's phenomenal. I also really love Spider-Verse. Spider-Verse / Bad Guys, because those are made by the same composer, Daniel Pemberton. I'm probably assuming he's going to come back for Across Spider-Verse, but it's it's just phenomenal. I love it. I think Spider-Verse really captures the intensity along with Miles's journey, and can be really, it's also kind of got like a soft techno to it, and it's more electronical music than orchestral, but there's some in there, and it's really, really good. Bad Guys, it's fit for a heist movie. You can definitely tell by the music. So yeah. And chase scenes have a lot of more band / orchestra composing. It's really good. It's really a lot. I also like just kind of other movie soundtracks. So I love Up. I love Up's soundtrack.
Disney Pixar. Oh my god, the Up soundtrack is.
A lot of people really like Married Life, but I would even argue that Stuff We Did from the score is even better, because a lot of people really enjoy the first 15 minutes of the movie. Obviously, I think everyone has seen it at this point, so it's sad. It's very sad, but I think towards the end it's even sadder. But it's just really happy. It's also a turning point in the main character's journey. And you can tell by the music. So I'd argue even that is my favorite over Married Life. And I love Married Life. It holds a special place in my heart. So
yeah.
I also like, I just like a bunch of stuff. I really just enjoy a bunch of movie soundtracks. Currently Puss in Boots' soundtrack has me on my knees singing. So
Bryan is knees begging for more.
I also love Shrek. I love Shrek 1 and 2 soundtrack and score. It's very intense and sometimes, but also very intense. And I love the cover of I Need a Hero. In Shrek 2. If you have not heard it, please go listen to it. It's phenomenal. I'd argue it's even better than the original. So,
you just pissed off so many people, Bryan.
I love, let's see. That was what I was thinking of. Oh, I also really love Wall-E. I love Wall-E's score.
Wall-E, yes.
I like Wall-E. It's special to me on a number of levels. And the music just adds to that. It's just a cute little love story between two robots, and they don't really say anything in the beginning of the movie. In like the first in the first act of the movie, they don't really say anything. And that, I think that's also amazing in an animated film when it's able to have emotions projected and able to portray feelings and that kind of love without the main characters even like saying a word, like a human word. And the music just adds to that. It's very, I love it. It reminds me of space because obviously it's set in space. It's got such a careless flow to it. Very nice.
I haven't seen Wall-E or Up in quite a while, but
they're very good.
Yeah, they're really good. About a year or two since I've seen the movies.
Yeah, no, it's they're good films. You gotta watch it. I also really like Laika's Paranorman that came out in like 2012. So like a decade.
I remember, yeah, you had your like
that I was I had like a short phase where I was
we say phase
era. No, that's longer. Let's not even get into eras. Eras are longer. It's like it was just a little moment in my time because I really that's when the movie was on Netflix. So I was like, ooh, I remember this movie, but I don't remember.
And then, like every day at school, you'd come up to me and the homies like, watch it now.
I hope you did because they took it off Netflix and now I can't watch Peak anymore.
So, I never watched it because I never knew what you were talking about.
How could you?
And some of the drawings, I'm like, oh, cool. And then the day I was going to watch it, that's the day they took it off Netflix.
God. I like Paranorman's score. It's it reminds me specifically of like an autumn day. Specifically, the piece Norman's Walk. That is a that's a song. It, I don't know. I like to listen to it, and it makes me feel like it's fall or autumn. Like I can just imagine walking down the street, with leaves, brown and orange leaves crumple on the floor. Fall is coming. It's got such a, I don't know. For me, the movie in general has a November, October feel.
Like November, October feel.
October feel to it, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I like Turning Red soundtrack. Movie is, I like the movie. And I thought the soundtrack was pretty good too. In some parts. And yeah, just a bunch of other stuff I really like. But I like even the more, I wouldn't say obscure, but I liked, sometimes I don't even listen to like entire albums. I just like one song and I pick from it.
Are you pickpocket songs?
Basically.
Yeah.
I also like Fantastic Mr. Fox. That's from that's a movie. And I like Mr. Fox in the Fields. That is also a pretty autumn feel like movie and song. I actually watched it with my sister last fall, and I don't regret it. It's such a good movie, and I want to watch it again whenever I can.
Nice.
So yeah,
I think for me, I don't really watch that many animated films. Mm-hmm. So I think the one that sticks out to me is obviously the Spider-Man one, Into the Spider-Verse. Because, I mean, one, the soundtrack is rap, and I love rap music.
Yeah.
So I already was, like, on board with it, and I'm like, all right, we're doing this. We're listening to it, and we're done. I think another one that I like very much is... I think the other one that I like is... I don't remember what it's called. We watched it last summer. Oh, Rise of Gru. I like the soundtrack.
Rise of Gru.
Not the soundtrack. The score. Like the music was really good. Honestly,
yeah, it was good.
It was really good. Like it fit with the theme of the entire movie, and I'm like, this is so good.
Yeah, I especially like the intro sequence. It was trippy. It's very trippy, but I like it. I have it saved on my playlist because it's really good.
Yeah. I think another one that I like is The Incredibles.
Oh, yeah. I like The Incredibles. I love The Incredibles, yeah.
The Incredibles
I've only seen it maybe a couple times. But Michael Giacchino does a good job with that superhero aesthetic, the superhero themes and everything.
Yeah.
It really sets the mood for the rest of the film, especially the intro sequence. So...
Mm-hmm.
It's very good.
And then I think one more. Probably the Cars soundtrack and score.
I like the Cars. I listen more to the Cars soundtrack than the score. I like the soundtrack more. I like Shaboom. I like Life is a Highway. I like all of them.
I remember when I was a little kid when that movie came out. Like I was like 2 or 3 years old, and I watched that, and I still love this to love it to this day.
It really resonates with a lot of people. So I really enjoy the soundtrack. Yeah, it's very very good.
It soundtracks and scores in general will always be a part of. Media, any form of media, really. Whether that be a movie, TV show.
It's such a pivotal and important part when you make
media, like really any form of media.
Yeah, like trailers. It's important
for trailers.
Catches your attention, you know, not just with the flashy visuals, but also the music. Depending on what type of movie it is, if it's like a romance, obviously, exactly. It will.
Like
will be a romance-like kind of theme. Action will be a lot of drums and it's just bass. A lot of loud noises to really get to you.
Yeah.
Horror movies, they'll have almost kind of little music to them. Or little really
music, but like it's suspenseful when it hits.
It's suspenseful, yeah. And yeah, that's the thing. That's the thing. It's not just the, you know, it's horror scores, romance scores, action scores. All of them have one thing in common, which is just to provide emotion, which is just to give that experience to the viewer, to the audience, to really get you invested into the movie, along with different aspects as well. So it's really important because without music in anything, first of all, if I didn't have any music, I'd probably die. I wouldn't.
Same. I'd probably lose myself.
Not like I just wouldn't. I just would like, come on, dude. Like
for real? We're like that one. We're like that.
Listen, I can't bop to we're my.
We're just sitting there in a corner. Like in an insane asylum, like with the wrapped around, like with your hands and everything, and we're just in the corner, like, God, I need music, man. I need music, man.
Sorry, and even if I don't have music, I'll probably eventually make my own. It's just, you know, it's natural.
Honestly, Bryan, I wouldn't be surprised if you grow up to be a composer.
I would honestly like that. I think that would be
even if. If like, say like your art career didn't go the way you wanted, I honestly see you as a music teacher, like really? The orchestra teachers. that'd be really cool to see you be like an orchestra teacher and like huzzah.
Music is such an important thing in my life. And I love to hear it. I love to hear all different types of music in the movies that I like to watch because it really gets me invested. And just because sometimes it's catchy and it like just gives me an itch in my brain. So, you know, I like to listen to it. Very nice.
Yeah. Well, that about wraps up for this episode. So thank you for coming on the podcast once again, Bryan.
Thank you for having me. Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Yeah. This is gonna be obviously everywhere, so please follow this man's Instagram and Twitter and everything. I'll put his link in the description.
I do art. Sometimes from consistent.
Actually, if you didn't watch the last podcast, he made the background for the last of a special the last episode. So again, check out his art. It'll be linked in the description below. And of course, follow my socials just to be up to date on when I will post podcast episodes. And anything else you want to say, Bryan, before we end it?
Pepsi, please promote me. I have drank like products. Just please call me, please. Listen, I will talk very good about your product if you just give me free Pepsi for life.
For life? Oh my God.
I'll fax you the number.
but that wraps up for this episode. Thank you all for watching or listening. And I will see you guys in the next episode.
Bye. Pay your taxes. Or don't.
Bro, no!
Or don't. But that didn't come for me.
Oh my God, Christian, you little bitch.
Yeah, drinking dope, turn me to a superhero. Hit that pill, turn me to a superhero. Boom, my 90s, turn me to a superhero. Metro, don't trust you. I'm in that dope again, I'm in that flow again, switch up the flow.